sets up a final with the defending champions, Chris and Gabby Adcock, who won the title a year ago. It's their first appearance in a Super Series tournament final since that final a year ago. And they're up against a pair who will be appearing in their sixth Super Series tournament final this year when making their first appearance at the Super Series finals. What a story for the Chinese youngsters. So just one more semi-final to come, one more men's doubles, and then all final places will be decided. It's the two-time beaten finalists over the last 2 years, Chai Biao and Hong Wei, up against the Olympic silver medalists Govi Shen and Tam Wee Kyong of Malaysia. So there are the Chinese pair. Oh, crikey, there's a fair bit of strapping on the Achilles of Hong Wei. We didn't see that yesterday. And here, their opponents, the Olympic silver medalists. And of course, for Chai Biao and Hong Wei, they ended the Olympic Games fourth. They lost the bronze medal playoff match. And having been beaten in the final of the Super Series finals for the last 2 years, they're trying to make it three finals in a row. And indeed, we'll try and go one stage better than the last 2 years. So the last of our semi-finals about to get underway.
This is the Dubai World Super Series Finals Men's Doubles second semi-final. Let's hear it for the players. First out, the number three seeds from China, Chai Biao and Hong Wei.
Beaten finalists in 2014 and again last year, Chai Biao and Hong Wei.
And let's hear it for their opponents, the number two seeds from Malaysia, Govi Shen and Tan Wee Kyong.
The world number one ranked pair. The Olympic silver medalists Govi Shen and Tan Wee Kyong making their debut at the Super Series finals as a pair. Tan Wee Kyong having competed twice previously with Hung Tien Hao. Well, a first ever Super Series title for this Malaysian pair in Denmark earlier this year, having been beaten in the Olympic final. Bright from England is our umpire for this. Steve, I've immediately noticed that the strapping on the left Achilles of Hong Wei. Now he had to pull out of the Denmark Open after just 3 points because of that Achilles, and then withdrew from the French Super Series the following week. So I am a little concerned about that. But let's look at Govi Shen first of all, the 27-year-old from Kuala Lumpur. Number two on the Super Series standings, having competed in all 12 tournaments. They won final this year at Super Series level. They won in Denmark, as I was saying. Tan Wee Kyong, born in Luar in Johor, moved to Sabah on the island of Borneo when he was a youngster, but now living in Kuala Lumpur. They've been in three finals in total this year, but just that one Super Series, as I say. And as far as their group matches are concerned, well, they had a walkover in the very first round of on Wednesday because the three-time former champions, Bowen Mogensen, sadly, Bo, not feeling well. Then on Thursday, beat the number six seeds, Li Jinhui and Liu Yucheng, who've been in two Super Series tournament finals this year. And yesterday, had three games against their opponents of today. And that was 47 minutes for 22-20 in the deciding game. Well, there, Chai Biao, he's actually been in three finals because he was beaten finalist in 2011 when playing with Guo Zhengdong. Lost out to Bowen Mogensen. Beaten finalists for the last 2 years, the pair that have been as high as two in the world ranking, a total of 5 weeks at number two, but finished the Super Series ranked three, and that is what their world ranking is as well. So their previous matches, well, of course, they also had a walkover against Bowen Mogensen, because once a player has withdrawn from one match, they can't come back and play anymore. So it actually transpired that their first match on Wednesday against their teammates Li Junhui and Li Yucheng, which they won in three games, was very, very important. So this is the 10th meeting between these two pairs, and of the previous nine, Gofi Shem and Tan Wei Qiong have won six of them, including yesterday. So Mike Wright,
ladies and gentlemen,
from England, our umpire.
On my right, Chai Biao from Hongwei, China. On my left, Gofi Shem, Tan Wei Qiong, Malaysia. Chai Biao to serve to Tan Wei Qiong. Love all. Play.
So the three-time finalist, Chai Biao, getting this men's double semi-final underway.
Oh,
good shot from the tall man, Hong Wei. 6 foot four.
Love.
Now, Steen, I was concerned, as I say, about the strapping on the Achilles. We didn't see that yesterday, certainly not to that extent. There was a little bit of strapping, I think, yesterday, but considering he's had to pull out of two of the Super Series tournaments in the autumn, that is a little concerning.
It is indeed concerning. And I mean, this is a knockout match, so he's going to be able to go all out physically. Yesterday, both pairs were qualified ahead of the match. Let's see if we can notice anything from his movement. Yeah. Yeah, he's... We can see it already now that he's not really putting a lot of weight on that left leg.
Over. 3, 2. Oh, good return. Well, we were talking yesterday, weren't we, about Tan Wei Qiong and his capabilities from the front of the court. See the struggling movement again. I know that he was pulled to the left-hand side of the court, but then trying to change direction.
And he was taking a long, long step on right leg and hoped that it would be enough. That jump was real solid, so... Maybe it's just, when you got a strapping on, you feel that you have a strapping on and are a little bit careful.
this match has got a very different sort of feel to it than it did yesterday. Yeah. Much more intensity.
That will, in my opinion, always be the case when you have a match in a knockout phase compared to a match where both pairs are secured promotion to the knockout phase.
Six, five.
Gone in the racket as he played that one.
Service over. Six.
Service return from Tanwi Kung.
Seven, six.
Broken strings, isn't
no.
it?
It could be. It's a little bit wobbly there where the string meets the frame.
Gathering of Malaysian fans not from far from where we are.
Oh,
that's super shot.
Yeah, it is.
He's got wonderful, wonderful touch at the net. Great reading of the game as well.
Over.
So to the mid-game interval, the Malaysians with the advantage. 2-point advantage. 8 minutes into the match.
Awful lot of emphasis on the service situation, and I can understand why, because I haven't seen a whole lot of long rallies where the defense turns around to the attack, and again has turned around to the defense and so on. So both pairs really, really strong in the attack. That means if you want to get the upper hand in the rally from the beginning.
20 seconds. 20 seconds. Eleven, nine, play.
Oh, that's a good smash. Good jump too from Chai Biao.
Service over.
Also a little look from Tan Weiqiang. Tan Weiqiang after the smash towards the Chinese pair. He did that pretty well.
Yeah. When he was pulled across courts, Hong Wei, I thought that was a little bit laboured. He was definitely not 100% with that Achilles. There's nothing wrong with that jump, though, is there? Crikey.
Service over. 11, 12.
Yeah, he's landing on that left leg too.
There might be a little impact, but it's nothing that is exploitable the way I see it.
Service over. 13, 11.
It's a better start the Malaysians have got today than yesterday. By Govichem.
Oh, yes. Chai Biao playing very well today.
Service
he
over.
Is.
13,
accepting. making the difference.
14-15.
Nod of approval.
Service over. 16-14.
Chinese pair, very, very good when they can play from above the tape. A little bit more human when they have to play from below the tape, the soft touch shots. It's not their speciality.
Service over. 15-16.
Oh. Service over. Such a good start, serve to start the rally, considering
17
he made an error
15.
Just a moment ago on his low serve.
Oh, it's a fantastic serve.
Goal. Service over. 16-17.
I think goal had him covered there. That one.
Yeah.
He was ready to return it behind Tan Wei Kyung.
And furious, isn't it? It's great for us to watch, but I wonder if somebody should start just mixing up the pace a little bit.
Play.
A good service return from Go set it up because Hongwei couldn't get the right length
17.
On that lift. That allowed Tan Wei Kyung to kill it.
It's the smash that sets up the partner to be able to finish off the rally.
Play.
Playing great here. The Malaysians. 20. We saw in the first group match
game
against Li Junhui and Liu Yuchen that they were really up to their best when it was close. Both the games they won had a score line of 19 all before the Malaysians eventually won
service
both games
over.
After 18. Having lost the, lost the first.
Second game point opportunity is converted. by the Olympic silver medalists. Go to Shem and Tan Wee Kyong.
And Tan Wee Kyong, 21-18.
In 18 minutes of play, 21-18. Two seeds. Super Series finals playing with Chinny Wee. Of course, the first year of the Super Series, 2007, we didn't have any Super Series finals. Super Series finals started in 2008.
Second game. Love ball. Play.
So one game to the good. 21-18, and opening game.
Service over. One, love.
Oh, what a great backhand.
Two, love. Service over. One, two.
There's so much of this play here around the net that is so fast that it has to be instinctive, because you can't really manage to think as well and remember what to do and so on. You can. Before you start the rally, you can decide for yourself, what am I going to do, what am I going to cover? Wow, what a smash there. Yeah. But it's got to be practiced over and over and over again, so it's immediate.
Four. And just automatic.
One. Automatic.
Between the first and second game, was saying something to Govee Shem about angle of attacking shot.
Yeah, that's possible. He has a tendency to play very hard smashes that tends to be a little bit flat. So definitely angle would be a good variation.
Yeah.
But a very, very powerful smash, we should say. Perhaps the most powerful.
Service over. 5-3.
Don't think we've had a challenge yet in this men's doubles, have we?
No.
service over.
He's a little bit too late with his racket there, Chai Biao.
4-5.
Got to launch the serve and immediately cover over his right shoulder.
Yeah, just changed the angle of the low serve there. And that was clever.
5-4.
Yeah, instead of serving to the tee, look, it's awkward for Hong Wei. He was expecting to play the backhand return, but it was really coming towards his right shoulder.
And he almost committed to that backhand return and wasn't able to change it.
6-5.
Yeah, there's that flat smash.
That one would have been possible to counter-attack if Hong Wei had been a little bit shorter.
6-4. Service over. 7-6.
It's very, very small margins that decides these men's doubles. We saw it with the service from the Malaysians that just changed the position just a little bit, and that's what gives you a split-second advantage if you can get the opponent to hesitate a little bit because you're doing something that they didn't expect.
He was quick on to that return of serve, wasn't he? Tan Wei Qiu.
8-7.
From that mid-court area, very sharp. Into the lead for the first time in the second game, the Malaysians.
Service over.
From Hong Wei.
9-8.
Came down from 2.94 meters, that smash. I don't know if you've been with us all day, then you've seen Mads Peter Colling of Denmark, and he is able to get it down from 3.15 meters. Jump and a long arm and a racket.
Yeah, now that's a steep smash, isn't it? We were talking about earlier.
Service over.
And that spells trouble for the tall Chinese players.
Yeah.
9-all.
Yeah, but it'd been set up as well with a change of pace with the drop shot.
We shouldn't get ahead of ourselves with the events happening here, but I think it's really, really interesting to see if these two Malaysian players can follow up on their Olympic silver medal. I read that Fu Haifeng is retired. He's gone into coaching. So that means that they're the highest active placed men's doubles at the Olympics.
Yeah.
It'll be really interesting to see if they can dominate.
10-9.
And of course, with the retirement of Lee Yong-dae as well from South Korea,
who has been the dominant men's doubles player with different partners.
Yeah.
Play.
World number one with three different men's doubles partners.
Service over.
So, who's going to have the advantage at the mid-game interval?
10-all.
Oh. Well, the answer is Chai Biao on Hong Wei.
10 interval.
Still 1.5 hours into the match. It really is all happening in double quick time.
It's been nice watching the men's doubles where we don't have these long preparations for the service situations, then one, two shots and another long, long preparation. I feel the flow is excellent here. It's entertaining men's doubles.
Play.
Oh, too big a swing of the racket, wasn't it, from Go Vi Shen?
12-10.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's too big.
Judgment. That's just wide. That's very good judgment.
Service over. 11-12. Play.
Deception in the defense there, I think.
Yeah, it was a sort of topspin, wasn't it?
It was. And the racket goes in the direction of the left-hand side, whereas the shuttle goes to the right-hand side. Fantastic. I don't know how he controls that first defense there, Go Vi Shen.
13-12.
That one.
And then there's the little topspin again on the backhand defense or lift shot.
But look at the differences in height that Hong Wei was hitting against Go Vi Shen. The first one was in his shoes, the next one was at his shoulders.
Bolts. Service over.
He's struggling a little bit with his low serve. Hong Wei testing it there.
Just that racket arm outstretched held it until the last moment. And that 14, little push from Tam Wee Kyong. So effective. It's been wide.
15-13.
This is a run of four straight points. Oh, wow. 16, this is a decisive 13. Move.
Yeah. The longest run in this game.
Yeah.
Hasn't been four consecutive points until now.
Make that five consecutive points.
17-13.
They've got to stop that streak. Chai and Hong.
Missed it. Yeah.
Service over. 14-17.
Chuck, there was the angle, steep and cross. Very, very hard to defend.
18-14.
It's magnificent, isn't it? Oh, broken strings,
yeah.
But it's gone wide. Oh, why getting away with that?
Service over.
Strings went, you could hear the sound of the shuttle off 15, the racket.
18.
That one.
Yeah, I think actually the one that he chose to play where his string broke, I think that would have gone wide as well. Imperative for the Malaysians to maintain their concentration and alertness.
Fantastic rally, long rally too.
Service over.
Pretty sure that was the longest rally of the match. Yeah, 42 shots. Oh, it's going good.
Service over.
Oh, we still haven't had a challenge, have we, in this?
16.
No.
Men's doubles.
19. Fault. Service
fault. Oh, service fault called.
Service over.
And that gifts match 20, point opportunities
match point,
to
16.
The Malaysians. Struck above the waist, says our service judge.
Game.
And they convert on their first opportunity. The Olympic silver medalists, Govi Shem and Tam Wee Kiong, 21-18, 21-16. In a little over 37 minutes.
Match won by Govi Shen and Tan Wee Kiong, 21-18, 21-16.
Just confirming that scoreline, 21-18, 21-16, in 37 minutes. And it was that run of five straight points that really made the difference from 12-13 down to 17-13 up. Doubles, we will have the number one seeds against the number two seeds in tomorrow's final. that means that tomorrow's men's doubles final will be the only final which will feature both the number one and the number two seeds. It is, of course, Kimura and Sonoda of Japan, the number one seeds, against the Olympic silver medalists Govi Shem and Tan Wee Kyong. What good men's doubles semi-finals they were. Real intensity today. Well, that of course means that all the semi-finals have been completed, and it started this afternoon with the first of the men's doubles, and the number one seeds Kimura and Sonoda coming from 15-17 down in that opening game. Six straight points to close it out, 21-17 and then 21-19 against the European champions Mads Conrad Pedersen and Mads Colling. Then in the men's singles, the Olympic bronze medalist Victor Axelsen has booked his place in a second consecutive Super Series finals final. He's up against, well, he beat Sungwan Ho in two straight games in today's match. Fourth match point he needed to convert that. Then the women's singles, and Sung Ji Hyung has set up a repeat of the final from 2 years ago, because she will be playing against Tai Su Ying, having beaten the Olympic silver medalist Pusala Venkata Sindhu in three thrilling games, an hour and 16 minutes for that one. In the mixed doubles, the three-time former champions Fischer Nielsen and Pedersen were beaten by the world junior champions from last year, and it was two straight games. The first ever victory for the Chinese pair over that Danish combination. As we've just seen in the men's doubles, the second of the men's doubles this evening, the Olympic silver medalists Govi Shem and Tan Wee Kyong beating the Chinese pair who had been in the final of the Super Series finals for the last 2 years. So that means that all the finals have been decided as far as who's going to compete tomorrow. And this is what the order of play will be. It's the Olympic champions Matsutomo and Takahashi in the women's doubles against the former world junior champions Chen Qingcheng and Zha Yifan. Then it's men's singles and the left-handed Tian Hao Wei against Victor Axelsen. Now, neither of those players have ever won a Super Series title before. Tian Hao Wei has been in two finals. Victor Axelsen has been in six. One of them is going to win a first ever Super Series title tomorrow. Women's singles, the world number one Tai Su Ying in a repeat of the final from 2 years ago when she won the title, and once again against Sung Ji Hyung. The defending champions, the only defending champions on finals day, Mr. and Mrs. Adcock, Chris and Gabby Adcock, are up against Sheng Shiwei and Cheng Qingcheng. Cheng Qingcheng, of course, in her second final of the day. And then we will finish with men's doubles. The number one and two seeds, Kimura and Sonoda, against Govi Shem and Tan Wee Kyong. It should be a terrific day on finals day tomorrow. It's been a terrific semi-finals day here today. Finals tomorrow are 1 o'clock local time. That's 900 GMT. From all of us here in Dubai, until tomorrow, it's bye for now.